Hey guys, just want to do a quick video on a simple TPO chart that you can make in Sierra Chart. I'm just going to do it kind of the simple way, not exactly how I do it, but just how normally it's done. So as you can see, I have just an intraday chart opened up. I went to chart and then chart settings, and I have the use evening session turned off. So this way we're only showing regular trading hours, since that's how I use my TPO. So now I'm going to go back out of that, and we're going to go to Analysis Studies, type in TPO, and then Add TPO Profile Chart. I'm going to click Apply, and I'm going to show you kind of what the defaults are. So as you can see, the default, by default, we don't have letters. These are going to be in blocks. And then you can also see this green line and these red lines, which these are the initial balance extensions. And so I'm going to go and change some of the settings. I don't want these extensions. And then I also am going to want this to be shown as letters. So go to Analysis Studies, go back into your TPO. And first thing you'll see is you can change the increments. So if we change it to 1, this will make it a lot more granular. But I'm going to just leave it at 2, click Apply. And then you're probably not going to want to switch any of this. Most of this should probably stay the same unless you have specific needs. And then we're going to go down here. I'm going to first go out and change the settings for the initial balance extension. So you can see right here, IBR extension display mode. Change it from horizontal lines to none. That way we don't get these initial balance range extension lines. Now that we have that done, I'm going to go in and add value area and point of control extensions. So right here, you can see we have extend value area, extend TPO point of control, singles, pour high and pour low. So for now, I'm just going to extend the value area and the point of control. And so there's two ways you can do it. Ideally is you can either do it to end of period, which will show until the end of that period. Once it's ended, it won't extend. Or you can show until further intersection, and that'll show all of the ones that haven't been intersected, and they'll keep continuing onward. And then same thing for the TPO point of control. So for right now, I'm just gonna put them until further intersection, or in future intersection. And then I'm also going to change the sub period price display style. I'm gonna change that from blocks to letters. And so you can see right now, all the letters essentially will overlap. And so to change that, you want to change this letter font size to 0 so that it will be in auto. And so that the font size will auto correct to however you're displaying the chart so that it's more visible. And then once we have that done, all there really is to do is more of the styling stuff. So if you want to change the outer edge where it's green, you can go to TPO letter block color, and you can, let's say, change this. So let's say I want it to be this blue color. I can do that. And then what I like to do is I like to go into here where we have the value area extension lines. I like these to be to gray, so I'm going to change that to gray. And then you can also label them. So if you want a short name, you can put value area lines. Since it doesn't differentiate between value area low and value area high on this. So, and then you can put name label right there, and then it'll show you all the extensions and have them labeled. And then you can also do the same thing. I'm going to do the same thing for point of control. I'm going to change it to yellow, and then I am going to put point of control as the name, and then check this box where it says name label. That way we can see all of these previous point of controls. And then you can change the styling as you like it. But this is pretty much the basics. It's not too complicated. And then when you're maneuvering around with the these profiles, you can right click and you can check or uncheck letter blocks in own column. So checking this will make it look more like a normal chart rather than a more like volume profile style chart. and then you can unclick it and that'll make it go back to normal. And you can also do this for individual ones by clicking this top one. So that'll do that for the individual ones. And then another thing you can do is if you want to merge profiles, you can right-click on a profile and then merge with the next one, or you can merge with the previous. So let's say we want to merge these days. That'll merge them, and then also the value area lines will adapt to that. So if you have any overlapping value, you can merge those profiles however suits you. And then if you want to undo that, you can right-click and go to undo all merges on this profile, or you can undo the leftmost or the rightmost. And that's about it.